Having an attitude of gratitude. Just a quick example. This is a little letter, a handwritten letter, and these, I think, go a long way nowadays in this sort of impersonal texting and digital world. This is from a fourth grader in Texas who wrote a handwritten letter to a meteorologist for coming to visit his school and teaching him about weather. "Dear Mr. Ramon, thank you for coming to our school and teaching us about weather. Someday when I become supreme ultra lord of the universe, I will not make you a slave." Now that's gratitude. That's what I'm saying. That's very tangible. You will live in my 200-story castle where unicorn servants will feed you donuts off their horns. And he goes on and on, and it's really quite funny, but we don't have enough time. But there's a picture on the back of the unicorn servant. But again, this is a keeper. This is a handwritten thank you note. Most of our managers, really our line managers, have no idea even how to write a simple thank you card, and those are some of the things we like to talk about. It's the soft side of business. You know, even a fairly serious publication like the Wall Street Journal found a connection between fist bumps and high fives and chest bumps and butt and back pats and all of that, and winning. In the 2011 NBA Finals, the Dallas Mavericks were supposed to just lie down and die to the superior talents of the South Beach Miami Heat. But they were far more cohesive. They might not have had as much individual talent, but they blew Miami out of the water that year. And the Wall Street Journal picked up on it, which I love. It pays to lighten up. So build a great culture, if you will, with levity. Remember, it's latitude, attitude, and gratitude. It's not just jokes, although that's always nice if you can steal a joke here and there and present it to someone. Remember to take it home. If you can be kind and loving and generous and wonderful and precious and all of that to people that you work with, for heaven's sakes, the ones that are your actual blood relatives deserve your very best. Sometimes you just got to stop in the driveway, take a minute, say a prayer, do whatever it is, you know, and go, please help me to be the same nice person to these people as I was so funny earlier. And vice versa. If you're funny at home, take it to work. So in conclusion, there's my final, there's a picture of family. But in conclusion, yeah, isn't it? Yeah, clap. Yeah, crazy. 26 years. 26 years, five boys. And she is way prettier now than when I, not that that matters. So remember, that's not anything I talked about. So remember, in conclusion, levity, it's not so much about being the next Jeff Foxworthy, who once said, if your idea of loading the dishwasher is getting your wife drunk, give it a minute, loading the dishwasher, anyway, it's fine. You might be a redneck. This is more about being the next Jeff Bezos of Amazon.com, who once said, we've got thousands of investors counting on us, and we're a team of thousands of employees all counting on each other. That's fun. It's not so much about being the next Will Ferrell so much as it is about being the next Will Bill Marriott, who said, greet your people, talk to them, get to know them, ask about their families, know them on as personal a level as they'll allow. It'll make all the difference. It's not so much about being the next Richard Pryor so much as it is about being the next Rich Kovacevich, former CEO at Wells Fargo, who once said, when no one's having fun, when people aren't thanked and appreciated, they lose interest and become disengaged. It's not so much about being the next Robin Williams, rest in peace, so much as it is about being the next Robin Gibb, rest in peace. I needed a Robin, what can I tell you, who once said with his falsetto singing chipmunk sounding brothers, what you doing on your back? See, if you don't say it that way, then it's not, what you doing on your back? If you know the song, you know what's next, don't you? What's next? You should be dancing. Yeah, nice. Dancing. I'm not entirely comfortable with this photo. But also, I don't know if you ever knew what those words were, but now you do, so I give you that. And I thank you for your time. That's a little bit of latitude, attitude, gratitude, the levity effect. Thanks, you guys.